as far as the essentials go, that's it. If you've got these things, a power supply, a motherboard, a CPU, and a stick of RAM, you're good. You can actually power up a computer. You don't need a case, you don't need drives, you don't need internal drives, you don't need anything else. Just those few basic parts, plug it in, maybe a monitor if you want to see what's going on. You don't have to see what's going on. You might not even need a mouse or keyboard, but you have those things, you're on. Your computer is working, okay? And actually, I usually plug up just a motherboard by itself like this with those few essentials, and we'll turn it on just so you can see. We got some time. All right. So as far as the essentials go, that's it. Now we're going to watch a couple videos. I'm going to show you where this video is. I'm going to show you where these videos are, then you're going to just have to watch all of these. It's going to just kind of go over some of the real basic stuff. We are going to go over it as a class anyways. For instance, all these things right here. All right, notice those are actually on the motherboard. Okay, all the ports on the motherboard are actually called onboard ports. And whenever you put this motherboard in, that's why you have some up here and then different ones down here. Okay? So these are called onboard ports. To go through them real quickly, you've got parallel ports, printer port, serial port, video port, mouse and keyboard. They're called PS2. These round ones are called PS2 ports. USB, a NIC, network interface card, and then audio ports. Like I said, you are going to have to watch all of these. I'm just showing you where they are. We are going to go over these a little bit later, but for now, we can go ahead and stop and continue. All right? So what I've done, go ahead and take your headphones off and everything. Close all your windows. What I've done is copied everything written on the back of this processor and copied it up here. Okay? So I'm going to pass this around so you can look at it if you'd like to take notes. If you can see the board, that's great. If not, hopefully you can see the processor. It's etched on there. Right? And all these processors have different markings on them. Okay? And we're going to talk about what all these hieroglyphics mean. All right. So first we've got Intel. Can anybody tell me what Intel is or what do they think it is?
Manufacturer.
That's right. This is your MFG. This is the company that made this piece, this part. There's two real big main manufacturers. There's Intel and AMD. Those are the big boys, okay? There's a couple others, but these are the big main ones. Intel's the ones that started it all. AMD is the big competitor. They have just as good pieces, half the price. Now, a lot of times I get people that ask me, which one's better? Because I think so-and-so is better. Well, it's the same question as asking you, what's better, Chevy or Ford? Don't answer that, okay? It's just a personal preference. Everybody has their own opinion, okay? Ultimately, what I always look at is specs, numbers, because numbers don't lie, okay? All right, so this is just your manufacturer. These are a couple copyright stuff. Next to that, that's the year was made. They won't always have the year it was made. This one just so happens. By the way, they won't always have the same information. All right, Pentium is the model, also sometimes known as the family of processor. The model of processor is a Pentium. 4 would be the version of that model. Some models have different versions.